Hello and welcome back to Thalric Plays Blood Bowl 2. Since the second match with the Orcs was cut short because of that disconnect from our opponent, we're going to play a third match with them. Let's take a quick look before we get started though. We have added our fourth Black Orc to the mix, so we're at 12 players right now. No level ups yet, because the MVP got on players without any SPP, but that's fine. Our team value is a little bit high for my taste concerning the skills we have, but I hope we'll be fine. So let's just try to find an opponent and see what we get. I wouldn't mind a team with a similar team value to ours, just so that things don't get too crazy while I'm getting the hang of orcs. And oh boy, yeah, this is going to be a problem. Um, 1450 Skaven. So we've got a Storm Vermin with Agility 4, a Thrower with extra arms and Strong Arm. Okay, that's not bad. Block Sidestep, block Strip Ball. Yep. What's that? Sprint movement allowance. Sidestep, so that's a one turn touchdown player. Sidestep, armor value 8. Armor value 8. Those are a little bit wasted. Block. And what does his 3 rerolls? Okay, yep, that's not going to be easy. So, we want a wizard. And what else? Let me see, what star players do the orcs actually have available? So we've got Avara Gulchur with Mighty Blow. What's that? Jump Up, okay, yeah, that's not bad. Morkenthor, Caripper. And that's it, okay. So, I think what we will be going for is one Babe and the Bribe. So we've got a Wizard, one Babe because we can't get anything else useful, and a Bribe. We don't really need the second Apothecary, I think, or the extra reroll, but we might want to foul something. So, yep, we are going to do that. But this match is definitely going to be very tough. Because we all know what Skaven can do, and they will be very dangerous. We don't have Tackle yet, which is actually one of the first skills I would like to get on a Blitzer. If not the first skill, I'm not sure yet. But regardless, this... I don't know, we'll see. We do have the strength advantage, and we'll just have to see how things turn out here. Okay. And I will set up a little bit different from before. Because we don't have to worry about frenzy this time. Or something similar. So what we are going to do is... well, we should pull those back a little bit. Probably. Or not. I don't know. Setting up against a fast team with a not-so-fast team is something I'm not used to, so I'm thinking right now, because... if they block here, they can just run through without a dodge. But if we move up to make things more difficult for him and force him to dodge at least once, we don't have a good reach. That's basically what this comes down to, but we probably still should do this. And instead... that pull wasted a little bit back, maybe. Yeah, let's try it like this. Or, you know what, quick change of plans. We're going to set up differently because we can. That I'm not sure if that's better or not, but it's what we're going with. And we're also going to do this if I can. Nope, I can't. Okay, so we only get one side there. Okay, our opponent's name is Adam, though, and he's playing with the Rollicking Rodents. And they all have names, and so he gave them his own names. And Fast Phil is who we need to look out for. And actually, I'm going to put on the skills this time. There's no big guys that can just block a lot, and that way we might have a little bit more of an overview. I don't know if it works for me. We'll see. Yeah, so this is a bit weird, and I'm not entirely sure on the orc setup yet against fast teams, so we're learning by doing here. Let's hope that we don't regret this. So what we want to focus on is getting one player down and then trying to foul the crap out of him, if we can. He has one reserve player, so our aim should be to, of course, bash him as much as possible without sacrificing too much defensive possibilities. He needs to commit a lot of players to the line of scrimmage if he wants to get good blocks here. He needs two assists, 1-2, to get a decent block against Orchiginal here, or against Warrior. Oh no, that's not good, so Fork is KO'd. Okay, bad start, very bad start. So you don't want to be a player down against Skaven. That's not how this should work. This also means that this is already a 2-dice, but without a block player. So I don't know if he will take that or not. And of course we can't say anything yet about his level of skill. His choices are a bit awkward. The plus armor value is not worth it. It's just a team value bloat. Plus movement allowance also would not be worth it on linemen. So if it wasn't a double, he should have just taken a normal skill. But yeah, that doesn't mean anything yet, because he also has that one-turn touchdown player that is really dangerous. And some sidestep and strip ball, which are all good choices. So that's a bit weird. But we'll see. He should push us there and not follow. He does not, so that's interesting. He doesn't want to be in a bashing match with us, so following up, not pushing us here is a little bit weird, I think. We'll see. He is not protecting the ball very much yet, so he should move some of his players over before he tries to pick it up. I've been on the receiving end of a failed pickup early on. Yep, so he's going to blitz first. And this agility for Stormvin is something I don't want to deal with as well. But it looks like he's not trying to put a gutter runner into our backfield in the first turn. So our defensive setup is okay for now. But we have to make sure that we don't leave too many holes for him to slip through. And also make it as hard as possible for him to go anywhere. And if I can get a good blitz on a gutter runner, we will take it. And hopefully foul him afterwards. So we want to go for this one. I don't know if we can get that. Or we might want to focus on this storm vermin, because we might be able to surf him. Yeah, we definitely need to go on this side now, because of his placement. Yeah, that should work out fine. The problem with Skaven, of course, is even if we make things hard here for him, he might just switch sides. But he pulled another gutter runner over, which he probably shouldn't have done, just to keep the threat alive here on this side. I don't know, we'll see. But we do have some ideas here. Okay, let's see. We do want to defend as best as possible. I also think we should go for this Storm Vermin, just because we do get a good setup for a surf here, potentially, in future turns. But we also need to move everyone over. At least a little bit. And now let's blitz this. Okay, good enough. And we will, of course, follow. That puts a player next to his ball carrier. Which should help quite a bit, I think. Also, he can't really get a good block here. So we should be able to make use of that. And let's put Wasabi over there. But we're going to keep Orcan probably here. These are all one, two dice. No, that's two dice. Okay. Yeah, of course. He can't really go over, so we might as well put him... Well, let's put him here, just to make these blocks even worse for him. And let's see what we can do here. That works. Let's put him right there. And I think we want to follow. And that's it. So I think our defense is okay at the moment. This is the weak point, because this is already a two dice. So he could go through here if he wants to. But we do have two players in the backfield that can run interference, and we can also pull others over. He needs to dodge with his gutter runners, otherwise we do get free blocks. And he put himself into a bit of a corner here, and he can't break through down there easily, I should say, because for one he needs to block Awakening first, and then he would need to go through what you're looking at. So yeah. It's okay at the moment, even though we are a player down. But, yep, that's what I was afraid of, and that's what why I was thinking if I wanted to follow up or not. Oh, come on. And he KO'd Warrior. Oh, boy. Yeah, this is bad. Not really nice. Good thing we have the Babe, I hope. As long as it works. He still needs to dodge to make it through here. So I probably shouldn't have followed, but if I hadn't done that, he would have gotten two players that could have moved anywhere he wanted to give assists, and that I really didn't want to deal with. And we couldn't really know that he would get lucky there, and lucky here again, apparently. He injured Orcan, of course. Yeah, that's how this works. So we're three players down in turn two. Yeah, not a good start. you don't want to be three, even one player down against Skaven. So we need to do something against that. The problem is, with so many players down, we can't really get a good foul opportunity. And it's risky to foul on top of everything. Oh, he rolled a double one. This might be our big chance here already. If we can make use of it. That won't be easy, though. Okay, so this... we probably need to start with this gutter runner. He's got sidestep, so he's really annoying and he can ruin our day. Oh boy. Yeah, I don't like this at all. But we don't really have a choice, so let's just go for it. Yep, not working. I don't want to reroll yet. Let's see where he decides to be pushed. Probably there. Nope. Okay, let's follow or not. Yeah, let's follow. Okay, this is a pretty big problem. Okay, we do want to have players on the ball. So anyway, we play this. This needs to happen. But he's got sidestep as well. Yep, this is... and he's got block. And that's the problem. My gutter runners don't really have those skills because I keep getting weird. Okay, and we don't see where he wants to be pushed, of course. Let's follow. Yeah, this is not what I was looking for. Okay, how do we play this? I can't reach the ball at all, and I can't even get a tackle zone on the ball, so the sidestep is really hurting me right now. I probably should have used the wizard first, but I didn't want to. Oh boy. Let's see. Maybe we get a lucky defender down. Nope, we need to take a reroll. Thank you. So at least there's that, and we will follow. An armor break would have been awesome, but we can't ask for too much, I assume. But this is probably our best bet to foul, actually, even though it will be with a blitzer. And the next thing we need to do is, well, we might as well. I don't really like doing this, but it binds players of him again, and he needs to get assists to make this worth his worthwhile. And then we will foul this gutter runner here. Because we get at least two assists. And that way we can, well, we only stunned him, but it's better than nothing. Yep, so he's going to move this guy to get the assist. He can get them both down, but he needs to put resources into that. And we couldn't really block here. His movement path was only two black orcs that are really slow. He can just run around us, and we wouldn't be able to really catch up. So if he picked up the ball and then made a good pass or handoff somewhere, we wouldn't be able to reach the ball, so we at least had to try this, I think. It's just really unfortunate that we got an injury and two KOs already. That makes things very hard right now. And if he hadn't gotten that double one on the dodge, things would be even worse. I probably made some mistakes here in my turn now. But there's not really anything we can do about that. And now we're basically screwed. With the way things are. Yeah. this guy. Oh boy. And he gets more blocks. Let's see. I mean, things are far from over, because it's really early in the game, but at the moment, things are not looking very good. But I might just keep fouling and move a few players over just to put pressure on him to score. That way, maybe we can even the score in the first half. It won't be easy, but we might as well try. And I will just keep stepping on this one gutter runner. If I can. We'll see. Yeah, but that's basically the total, the complete, my complete plan. Not a very good one at the moment, I admit. Oh, he's trying to dodge away here. It's not that unlikely. It's a 3 plus and a 2 plus dodge. Yep, makes it. Oh well, it is what it is at the moment. Nothing we can really do about it. I was considering blitzing with him to get a ball next to the ball carrier again, but it wouldn't really help us that much. Because he can just get a 2 dice block again and get rid of us, so we're not doing that. Instead, let's try to get a really good block against this player. He will be pushed over here, that's without a question. We might get a defender down, both down. That would prevent us, but we'll see. And I wanted to get a 3 dice block so that we have a good chance of actually hitting him. Thank you. So he will be pushed there. Well, he's not doing that. Okay, why? Only stuns. We need to get some KOs or injury in here. Otherwise, things will get problematic. And we might as well foul this one, because that way we are at least moving down the pitch. Which is what we want, of course. I don't like the block strip ball, but sidestep might be worse, and we do have sure hands, at least. So there's that. Yeah, let's go here. Or probably because we don't want to give him the assist, he will just dodge again. And then we go here and step on the gutter runner again. This time with a lineman. And nothing. Okay, that's too bad. Let's see what he does. He can't score this turn. Well, he can. He just needs to dodge this guy, run him over there, and then make a pass. Or something like that. But we'll see. I don't know how nervous the fouling makes him, if he is affected by it at all. He can get good blocks here again, but at least he only gets a push this time. Still, it frees up 2 more of his players. Yeah, this one is tough. And at the moment, I really don't know when I should use the wizard. Maybe if he keeps his players like this, I doubt that he will, but who knows. We might want to just go for a fireball and hope that we can injure or KO some of his players. But the lightning strike is usually the better choice, because it is a 5-6 chance instead of a 4+ chance. So we might just want to try and get the gutter runner. It all depends on what he does here. and how he positions himself. If he gives us a nice target, we might want to change our plans. But it looks like he doesn't want to score this turn. Yeah, he will put himself right there. No? Really? He needs to dodge with this guy and put him there to close his cage. But this is actually what I was talking about, and I think I will try the fireball. Four targets is good enough, I think. With the ball carrier under it. And if he will, if he closes the cage with this guy, we will have five targets. The alternative would be to try and get assists to get a corner here. And then get a direct blitz. Okay, he's doing that. That's not stupid. And it works. Let's see. Oh, come on. Really? If Skaven start beating up orcs, things are starting to get really ridiculous. And the biggest problem right now is that I don't think the wizard will actually do us any good. But we're still going to try. I think it's our best bet here. Let's just hope that we get something good. Okay, just two? Just two. That's unfortunate. And no injury again. Which is what I was hoping for. But we can't choose what we get. Okay, what's next? Yeah, just barely. Oh no, I screwed up. Yep, I'm just stupid. This is getting on my nerves a little bit here, unfortunately. So I just screwed myself out of a two dice. Because I made a mistake. We needed to put an assist here and then blitz with this guy. Which we didn't do, and we can't, so all I get to do here is one dice. Not what I wanted. Okay. We might as well try. What? Oh, nope, it's just... Yeah, I'm dumb. We need to take a reroll. And it's not helping. But he should be... He should choose to be pushed back here. Well, not okay. So this is down to my own big stupidity right now. The problem is probably even going there, he can just dodge back, run around, and reroll a one for going for it. Yeah, I'm not playing a good game right now. I mean, we are a bit hampered. Is that the right word? I don't know. Yeah, let's see if he just dodges and scores. That might actually be a blessing, but we wasted the wizard, basically, because we didn't get an injury. Just a stun. Even though we hit five targets. So we rolled a one, a five, a three, a one. I don't know. Yeah, not really good, but he can just score if he wants to, but he might stall. I don't know how this guy ticks, and he's not playing a bad game. His choice of plus armor value is still weird and not really worth it in my opinion, but aside from that, he's playing a good game and he's capitalizing really big on getting a four player advantage here. And I can't break his armor, and even if I do, we only stun. So yeah, and he's going to stall this out. So that's a bit of a problem. works because he's got block and we don't. Okay, yeah. This is not getting any better. But if we can, we should try to hit... Oh, come on. I just hate the auto-adjusting camera. Yeah, he can make that a two dice if he stands this gutter runner up and doesn't move him. If we can, we should try to hit his one-turn touchdown player. We can't hit any of this directly. At least not at a reasonable... with reasonable success. And he starts doing one dice blocks. This is getting cocky. Okay, what can we do here? Not a whole lot, to be honest. We can still try to target his gutter runners. And we will do that. So let's start with this one. Nope, not going to help. Yeah, we should stand him up first. We can't reach this guy reasonably for a good block. We probably should just ignore this and focus on the ones we can hit better. So, this one. And... yeah, let's just try. Thank you. I don't know. Doesn't really matter where he's going to be pushed. Oh, come on, please just give me anything other than a stun here. One injury. Too much to ask? Maybe two. That would be awesome. But I will foul again. So there's that to look forward to. And that's also why I'm not going to follow up with a black orc. Oh. Another stun. We're not getting through there. And then we can step on the storm vermin. And we finally get a KO out of this. Did he just use his apothecary? He did not, okay. But we did get one KO, so that's really good. And then we're going to put Wasabi up there just so that he can't get good assists here without pulling players away from here. And if he just sticks to his to scoring in turn 8, we can live with that. Because we will get an 8th turn. It's not like we will be able to do a 1-turn touchdown, not with orcs. And I can already hear... them all saying, oh, I should have taken the troll and the goblin for a throw, but nope, not doing it. But what I wanted to get to is that we will get two KO roll chances, so with one babe, odds are we should get them all back, and that would mean we're back up to 11 players with our reserve player here. We've seen it happen differently already, so I don't know. And the way the roads are at the moment, it might not go that way. But we'll see. So he will move one other guy over here to get an assist. But this is probably not going to happen. And if he stalls this out, I will use every opportunity to keep fouling as long as we have... as long as we have that bribe, we can be pretty offensive with that tactic. but he keeps moving his gutter runners away. But there's still this one here, which we might just want to step on. And we can also reach his one turn touchdown player, and if we can get rid of that, that would be perfect. And we have three players to get there, so him, then a blitz might mean we won't get a good foul opportunity, but that wouldn't be too bad. Yeah, that's a two dice against, you don't want to do that. And fail the dodge, maybe? Mayhaps? Nope, not happening, unfortunately. But we can't get them all. And he should take a reroll. It was his last action and he has exactly three rerolls left, and it was his third last turn. So there was no real drawback to doing that. And we could just step onto his thrower, but I think going for the gutter runners is still the better choice, so we will try to do that. And we will also focus on getting a three dice block, which this is not yet, so let's move Wasabi right there. Oh, did he leave himself open? He left himself open to be blitzed here. We need to try. I cannot try. Yeah, this needs to happen. And it needs to happen first, because we need to see how this goes. And I will take my last reroll for that. Doesn't change anything. Will he choose to be pushed into the touchdown zone, though? Otherwise, he should be pushed there. He could score on our turn now. That would cost him one himself, I think. Okay, he's not doing that. But yeah, we can't block him there. So that dictates our remaining moves, which means we are going to foul this gutter runner. It's the cheapest one he has, basically, but every gutter runner we can get rid of is good. And that's a death. Oh boy. And he shouldn't use a reroll for that. And now it's time to use the bribe. Okay. Not exactly the result I was thinking about. I didn't want to kill one of his players, but still, it's a player gone. I don't know if I will keep fouling. Maybe not in this half. It depends on what targets we get. We'll see. And we are actually putting pressure on him again, so maybe he will not stall this out. I mean, if he blitzes with this guy, he does get a two dice, but he needs to do a going for it to get that. We'll see if he gets it. Yep. And he gets a good block there. He should just push us there, and that's what he's doing. Oh boy, yep, that's a... Okay, he should have pushed us there, moved up this guy, and then pushed us out. Good thing he didn't do that. So I assume he will try to stall even longer. Nope, he didn't realize that he scored us automatically once he reaches the end zone. It's actually better for him that way, because he gets two chances of getting his KO player back instead of just one. Okay, the Black Orc stays out, the other ones come back. So we're at 10 against 10 at the moment. And we have two turns without a reroll to even the score. It's not impossible, but it's highly unlikely. The blitzers are, in theory, fast enough. We would need to go 13 spaces, so 2 times 6 plus 1 going for it. Assuming he pushes us back, that would make it 2 going for it. I will try to score, but I'm not very optimistic about my chances here. So, yeah. But that also gives us more free chances to beat him up, potentially. And that's always nice. Well, we actually probably should put him back even further. What else? We need to put these up. And then let me think if we... Yeah, let's do this. Yeah, I'm not in love with this specifically, but it all depends whether or not we screw up a block or not. That we even get the chance to attempt this. And that seals it, basically, because the riot is... We only have one turn left, we can't score. It is what it is, but it's fine. We do have the second half to try and make it better. And maybe we can get something out of this last turn, after all, with a little bit of luck. And I am already debating if I want to foul or not. No armor breaks yet. So we still should try to hit this one, probably. Or, alternatively, we should try to hit his thrower. But considering that we're receiving, we would like to go after this one. So that's probably what we should do. That's a 3 dice. Nope. What? Yep. Well, I was confused there for a moment. Why that showed only 2 in the beginning. Okay, thank you. That's good. And we'll follow. And that would give us the opportunity to foul, but I want to try to pass first. It's highly unlikely, but it's the better choice first, so we should do that. Let's run back up. Okay, nice. And even though it might cost us this player for not that much, we should still try, I think. Maybe I'm overdoing it, but I like the opportunity. Oh, we only stunned him, so that was a waste. Okay, yeah, I'm still learning the ropes with the orcs, and this match is not going well so far. His KO player comes back. That's really bad. But at least ours comes back as well. But that still means we are at 10 players, and he's at 11. Okay. What we need to do? Score as late as possible. If at all possible, take out his one-turn touchdown guy. And aside from that, cause general mayhem. It won't be easy, but we'll do our best. Okay. And we actually do have some decent targets here. What I'm worried about is that he might just get a blitz. And that would be very bad. And also that we overcommit a little bit here. So, where do we want to go and who do we want to hit? I really want to hit this guy, but that would put us in a situation that would leave us exposed to a surf. So I think we're going to try and blitz his... try and blitz his thrower this turn. But still, in case of perfect defense, we don't want to be directly on here. So we're going to pull back a little bit. We're not completely safe against the blitz, but at least we should be okay, I think. Okay, changing weather is not a big deal. That positioning, though, is horrible for us. Okay. Come on. Thank you. So it's 10 against 10. That's a good start. That's a really good start. Before we do anything else, we want safety on the ball, which means moving award winner there. Okay, that worked as I hoped. And then we will still hit his thrower. That will cut them off a little bit, which is really nice. Yeah, let's actually just go for both down. That works. And do I want to move him? I think I do. We need to be a little bit careful with our positioning here. But I think it should be okay. And I will not try to pick up the ball this turn because that would mean doing a going for it. Which I really don't want to do. Let's do this one next. Not quite good enough, but it's fine. Okay, what else? We probably want to move up Warrior to here. And we keep Orcsity back here. Well, we probably should put him there, I think. They won't be able to run around over this way. You know what? Let's put him right there. That's probably a good spot, I think. We'll see. But getting the early KO was important, just so that we have the same amount of players on the pitch. And we can make more use of our strength advantage. We're not fully implementing it at the moment because we only have two Black Orcs into contact, but these two are at least a good bulwark defensively. And we basically get free blocks against these guys next turn, or should most likely get free blocks. In this case, his armor value is working for him, but on higher team value, it's just not that much worth it. By then, teams will have Mighty Blow, and they're just too squishy, even with the armor value 8, to really stand a chance. And Wrestle or Block would be better. But we'll see. I assume he will... Okay, he's moving them back, okay. He might pull this guy over that way, though. I don't know. And he is actually giving us free blocks here again. That does slow us down, and going there does not grant him the assist he's hoping for, because we still have this guy. Well, yeah, that still works if he wants. And he's actually going for a one die splits. That's cocky. And he gets it after a reroll. So that's really lucky. And not at all what we wanted to see. Yeah, works. But that is still fine at the moment. This is a bit of a problem. If he gets that, we're in trouble. But he doesn't. Okay, let me think. He just needs to stand up. This guy has sidestep. So even though I would love to surf here, we need to blitz from here. But we could blitz this guy. Nope, we need to blitz him. Just to block his possibility to be pushed onto the ball. That's annoying. Oh boy, let's stand up here first. Yeah, I'm not doing a good job at the moment, still. The problem here is as well that we need to get him away from our ball carrier. So let's try. With Orchid, we only push him. Let's see where he chooses to go. He should choose to go here. He's not, though. So I will stay. Yeah, this needs to happen anyways. And there's the reroll. Thank you. So at least we get that. And he's still got two tackle zones on the ball. That's just really bad. And we can't get any players free here to move them over. So I can't really afford to pick up the ball again. He's playing a really good game at the moment, and I'm not playing a very good one. On top of everything, so these are all one dice, so we need to do this one first. Oh, not what I was looking for. But I need to stay just so that this gets a two dice. Or becomes a two dice, I should say. And then we can do this one as well. Yeah, not really good. So we don't have block. He does have block. So I don't really want to block there. But I will try this one dice, even though it's risky. Thank you. So at least we have that going for us. And let's actually stay. Nice. So we get another KO, but at the wrong place. So this is far from safe. We do have some tackle zones on the ball. And he shouldn't be able to remove them all. But the gutter runners don't need every tackle zone to be gone to make this work. Yeah. It's just hard playing against a team with a higher team value. Especially with a bash team that has basically no skills against an agility team that can run circles around you. So yeah, that's not nice. I assume he's going to blitz here and push us onto the ball and hope for a good scatter. At least that's what I would try, probably. He only gets a push, which is really good, and he doesn't actually push us onto the ball. This is only a one dice, because we have this assist. And we have block as well. So if he tries to get that, it's risky, but he does, because getting one dice blocks against me is what my opponents do. So we only have this tackle zone on the ball remaining. Which makes this a 3 plus pickup on the ball. If he decides to take it, which he should, and he gets it. So this is basically the worst scenario right now. In our defense, he took the ball away from us. I don't know if I could have prevented that. This is a big problem. The way he pulled back might work for us in the end. Maybe. But we need to be careful now. Because what we can try is block this guy away, and now that guy as well. And then we can blitz with Awakening up there. But he is blocking that point of attack. Yeah, he definitely knows what he's doing. I don't like this guy. Well, I actually don't have anything against him. He's playing a very good game right now, and we need to respect that. But still, it's a bit annoying, because I would like to win, but at the moment it looks like we won't be able to. And we actually need to stay here, unfortunately. So, yeah. Not really what I was hoping for here. No! That was a misclick. That's a 6 plus dodge. I can't do that. Yeah, this is just bad. We didn't stand up this guy, and these guys can all go wherever they want. I mean, our defense is still okay, but he can just run down this way and we won't be able to follow him, really. He just blitzes this guy and then moves a few dead players into defense, hands off the ball to this one, and he's basically through again. And that's exactly what he's going for. Yeah, I'm not having a good game. That dodge was really dumb. I did not see that in time to stop it. Yep, okay, he's actually not going to blitz, apparently. Well, at least not yet. This is already a two dice now. And I didn't actually inflict a single injury on him yet, which is really weird. Yep, good enough. It's not like we have block or anything, but he does. So he'll most likely move there, I feel like. Yep. And knowing what he's going to do doesn't make this any better. I mean, I can still move Wasabi down here and blitz, but it's a really bad position. We still need to try and will try. Okay. Really? Yeah, go for it. Oh, wow, he rolled a double skull. And it looks like he won't reroll that, which is probably the correct choice. Unfortunately. So, yeah. And let's see, these guys can stand up. We won't be blitzing with them. but if possible, I would like to get this block. Oh, come on. I mean, it's good enough for what I have planned, but I really don't like that we don't get good results here. Yeah, we can move him up now in a moment, but we need to blitz first. And I will need to make going for it here to block this as best as possible. And I don't even get the result that I need. Yeah, we can push him there. And put Wasted over this way. This is actually not a bad position anymore. We might be able to pull this out. I'm not sure yet, but we'll try. Of course. I won't give up until it's over. And I would love to get the assist over here, but I feel like we should limit his movement options as much as possible. Which basically means moving Orchidional somewhere else. We could go here. Probably there would be better. I would love to be able to get here, but that's not possible. I really don't know. Let me think. If I go... So he can't really get a good block here. Yeah, we need to get a tackle zone on his guy there, I think. Because, oh, well, actually, this is really hard to decide. Well, actually, I am going to assume that this will work out. So we're going to do things a little bit differently. I am going for this. We'll take the two dice here. Take the result, and I need to hurry a little bit because we're running out of time, and then we'll move Fork back here. He shouldn't really be able to get good result here in any case, because this guy is in two tackle zones without any assists from his side, and he can't assist over there. They have only strength 2, so even if he gets if he pulls over here and gets one assist, this is a one dice. This is a one dice. This would be a one dice, I think. So he needs to go back. That's basically what it comes down to. And that's something we can work with for now. And we might be able to push him out, this one gutter runner. He actually is trying to get the one dice blocks. And re-rolling for it. That's really gutsy. Oh, I see. He wants to dodge here. That's 2 dodges. Oh, he does not, because that didn't go as well as he hoped. So he's going back. Possibly out of reach. Yeah, we need to do going for it to get there. But still, we are in a better position than we were in the previous turn. And there's still 4 turns left for me to do something with. So maybe we can turn this around. I don't know. I really don't. But we'll see. Oh, he's trying to go there regardless. But with another guy. And he's making the right choice. He's going dodge for dodge. At least the first one, to see if he used up his reroll, which he now did. And now things will get difficult. That looks like he wants to do another one dice block. He shouldn't in this case, because if he fails, we have a player in range. If he gets it, it's good though, it's good. But we'll see. Nope, he's doing dodges first. Oh boy. Oh, he's getting the 2 dice block. But he is giving me a blitz there. And that's just a stalemate. Works for us. Okay. So we need to work on the gutter runner. It's still our best target here. I do want to get rid of his movement allowance 10 guy, if he can. He's got sidesteps though, so let's see where he chooses to be pushed. Okay, back there. Let's follow. No armor break. That's unfortunate. This is mainly for safety reasons. And I will use the aggressive approach here. And that we will do now. Let's see what this gets us. Not the result we needed, though. Unfortunately. We would have needed a defender down. Doesn't really matter, but we won't follow. Maybe we can put him in a position where he won't be able to dodge as easily. Let's try that. That's two more going for it, so I really don't want to do, but we don't really have a choice. Well, we actually did, but that way at least he will most likely dodge that way, which is a little bit harder for him to get. Then we'll do this one. Which is good enough, and we don't follow this. And this one as well. But that's only pushing. These will be two dice against, all of them, yep. I don't think we can afford to dodge here, unfortunately. So this is... he might possibly score this turn. What he probably should do is stand this guy up, then do the two dice. That frees up this guy. Push us there. I don't think that he will score, but he might try. We'll see. He will obviously go over to this side, I think. But he won't be able to make it that far. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, but he doesn't want to stand next to us, so he will most likely go either back here or there. This is pretty locked down. What he might want to do is dodge, go down there and just throw, but I don't think he will do that. Okay, he wants to go this way because that's where most of his players are. Okay, he wants to dodge again. I mean, he didn't use up his first dodge reroll yet, so it's not that bad of an idea. And it does allow him to get one space further, but still. And what I will do is try to dodge here and blitz, because that's our best bet. And that's another double one. Thank you for that. So let's see now. Everyone that can be moved needs to be moved. This needs to happen, I think. And I really don't like ignoring these guys, but we need to move. We need to move our players over. I don't know, we'll keep them like this for now. I will do this one next. It's another going for it I really don't want to do. But we don't have a big choice here. Okay, thank you. And then we can blitz. Okay, that worked already. That's really nice. And we get a defender down. Oh boy. But he's probably choosing to be going to go that way. Yep. Let's stay. Okay. Okay. How do we do this? I don't think we want to follow with this guy. And I feel like we need to move. Wasted. We need to move them all, unfortunately. I just need to ignore them, I think. I don't really want to, but I don't know if we have that big of a choice. And that's a turnover, because I don't want to use my last reroll. At least we stunned his guy. Still, it's not really a good trade. Okay, we have one tackle zone on the ball that he might be able to get rid of. What he probably should do is dodge this guy back to get the assist and then blitz with this guy. And then he can pick up the ball with this gutter runner again. Let's hope that he doesn't see that or just doesn't get it. but at least we're still kicking and it's not over yet. Okay, he's not blitzing with him, so he's probably going for a dodge with the Storm Vermin instead. The problem is we're at turn 15 in our next turn. So we only have two turns left to make a draw happen here. And even if we do, he does get a chance for the one turn touchdown. But let's focus on the now and what we can do to win to draw this game. Or tie this game. Okay, interesting. So how is he planning on doing that? I can't do words good. Does he just want to try to pick up the ball in through one tackle zone again? That might be what he wants to do. Nope, that's the setup for the blitz. Okay. Please fail. Oh, he does. At least good enough. It's not good, but at least his last reroll is gone, which might be important. And he still needs to pick up that ball now. But we're not in a good position, because that guy still does have block, dodge, and sidestep. And he probably doesn't want to keep it on this guy, so he will try to pick it up and then maybe pass it down. I don't know. Or he will just... We can attack him from basically anywhere right now. Okay, so he wants to go there. And block our movement as best as possible that way. But he fails the pickup. Oh boy. This is basically our last chance. Uh, I will still block him, not that it matters much, at least against this guy. Because if he can get to the ball, he will score. Okay, so what are our options right now? We do need a defender down. So we want three dice if possible, which means not blitzing with a blitzer, but with a black orc. So this is a three dice blitz now. Okay, will he choose to be pushed onto the ball? Yes. Let's stay for now. We should have movement left. We KO'd him, but the ball will still scatter, I think. Yes, but in a favorable position for us. Okay, so what is next? Next is this block, because we need to create an opening for us to run through. It's good enough for now. And that's Orchid. And that's 3-6. Okay. And I think we want to try to pick up the ball this turn. But we need to block this as best as possible first. Yeah, let's put him there. It's going for it, but we would need to do one anyways. I don't know if you want to go for a handoff, so we might as well try this. I really hope this works. Okay, thank you. But this is basically his best point of attack at the moment, and his only point. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let's do this one right away. Okay. And now we will go for the last block. I'm really nervous. I really hope that we can pull this off. But it does involve some luck. We luckily still have one reroll left. So even if he gets the block result that he needs, we still have two other players in range to possibly pick up the ball again and score. But he doesn't have a reroll left. So this needs a lot of good rolls. Okay, dodge works. Let's see what he gets. It's good enough. And Wasted is injured. Yeah, we don't need the apothecary, and he wouldn't help us anyways, so his guy leveled up. So, last chance. All we need is to pick up the ball. Oh, please, game. Don't screw with me. Thank you. Holy crap. We did it. Okay. And I should have used the apothecary for one reason only. It's the last turn. And that means he gets to do his one turn touchdown. And we don't have enough players to defend against that. So that's a problem. Let's see how well we can make this setup work. Not very well, apparently. Yeah, this is full of holes, so we need to do this differently. It wouldn't really change that much anyways, I think. And still, it's just about enough. So at least he will be forced to dodge, regardless. Okay, we have one more player we can actually put there. So we can do this a little bit better. So like this. And these are still the weak points, and we won't be able to get rid of those. That's just not possible. Yeah, doesn't matter too much. And if he gets it, there's just nothing we can do about it. He needs a lot of rolls, and he doesn't have a reroll left, so probability-wise, it's unlikely, I think. But you never know in Blood Bowl. It might happen. A perfect defense would be awesome right now. But it's just one. Oh, that scatter is actually. Nope, yeah, it's not good because it's near his guy. Over there would have been awesome. Probably wouldn't have changed that much, but you never know. Okay, he gets the pickup. Now comes the throw. Which works as well, apparently. And now that's three going for it plus two dodges. So that's 5 2+ rolls, or 3+. Yep, he makes it. Of course he makes it. So that's our first loss. But we almost got the tie after all. It's just that we can't do anything against that one turn touchdown. I tried my best to get rid of the player, and we weren't able to. That's just how it goes, but at least we didn't get any permanent injuries, but also no rank ups. Once again, or level ups, maybe with an MVP. That would be nice. Yes, Warrior or Black Orc actually leveled up. That's nice. That's really good. Getting the Black Orcs some skills is pretty important. So let's see what we roll here. A normal level up. So what we will go for first is just basically block. That's it. No fuss, no nothing else. We will just start with block, and that's it. So we lost this one, unfortunately, but still we're... I think in the end it was okay. I made some stupid mistakes, and being 3 to 4 players down in the first half really screwed me. But considering that, I think I can be okay with this result. We almost took the tie, and he only managed to win thanks to one turn touchdown player. And that wasted wizard certainly didn't help. But oh well, it is what it is. So next time we will try to do better again. And I don't know if I showed this actually during the creation video, and I don't know. I just don't remember. So our stadium is the waste of space. Okay, but that's it for this match. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like and a comment. And if you want to see me play more Blood Bowl and play more Orcs, just subscribe if you haven't already. The next match won't be with the Orcs again, but with something else. I just need to check. It's either Skaven or Lizardman again. And yeah, we'll go from there. So as always, thanks for watching. I hope that you tune in next time, and have a nice day. Bye.